New at 11 tonight, the South Carolina prison system is under fire after a judge ruled today it lacked basic mental health care that in some cases led to the death of inmates. News 4's Liz Lohuis joins us with more on this developing story. Liz?
Carol, the 5-week trial looked at the treatment of several mentally ill inmates, and Circuit Judge Michael Baxley said it was the most troubling of the 70,000 cases that have come before him in his 12 years on the bench.
A judge says change is in order for the South Carolina Department of Corrections after he called the treatment of seriously mentally ill inmates unconstitutional. The ruling today came from a class action lawsuit filed in Richland County in 2005 that told the stories of several mentally ill prisoners. The judge says evidence showed some inmates were not given their proper medication. Others were put in solitary confinement, in some cases for years at a time. And he says video showed some of the cells had blood and feces smeared on the walls.
You get in those kind of environments and it actually escalates people to think that there's more of a conspiracy against them.
Peyton Blau is the founder of Rehinge, an organization he says provides a voice of hope for mental health. Blau also suffers from bipolar disorder and spent many months of his life behind bars.
I believe out of the 1.2 million people behind bars and prisons in this country, that probably 200,000 to 300,000 of them aren't there because of a character flaw. They're there because of a medical condition.
The judge also ruled a lack of mental health care led to the suicides of several inmates.
I'm not sure he has the expertise to make that kind of statement.
Senator Mike Fair, who is also the chairman of the South Carolina Corrections Committee, says parts of the ruling are questionable.
You put them in lockup because they harm themselves. The judge says that they're harming themselves because you put them in lockup.
Fair says mental health care is not only a South Carolina problem, but a national problem, and agrees some reform is needed.
Baxley gave the Department of Corrections 180 days to prepare a plan to fix the issue. Michael?
Liz, thank you.